Hello student, in our previous lecture we study about the female reproductive system. In that female reproductive system there we are study about the main structure that we are known as the ovary. Then we study about the other structure that we are known as the oviduct, uterus, vagina and the suffix. This all the things are present in them. Afterward we are study about the external genitalia. In that we are taking that the mons pubic, labia major, labia minor and the clitoris. This all the structures are taken in them. But we have in female body one another structure is present, and that structure it is known as the what, a mammary gland. This structure it is a very important for the female body. Why it is important? Cause when the parturation will be completed, the baby is come out from the mother body, and after coming out the baby is needing the what, a nutrition, and that nutrition is provided by the mammary gland which is present into the female body. This mammary gland, they are produce the milk which is a very important for the growth of the baby, and that's why today we are start with the new topic, and that is called the mammary gland. If we are take the number of the mammary gland, then we can say that what we can say that one pair functional gland is present. Okay, if you are talking about the mammary gland, then they are the one pair, but they are the functional gland. It is called the mammary gland. Previously when we are discussed about the different structure, that means we are study about the mammary gland. So at that time we says that in male and female both of the mammary glands are present, but in male this mammary glands are not developed. They are just for the a part, but it is not related with the any a function. But in male, in female the mammary gland is present. There are the one pair, but it is in a functional condition. Why? Because after the parturation it has to care a baby, and for that it is very important. So what is the present in this mammary gland? What is the structure of that? So the granular tissue and the various amount of the fat is present. Granular tissue plus various amount of fat is present. That other word we can say that there are the tissues or the cells are present, in that the fat is present. That we are also known as the adipose tissue. The tissues in that the different amount of the fat are present. So here the granular tissue and the various amount of fat is present. But afterward that we take the granular tissue is divided in 15 to 20 mammary lobes. This granular tissue, it is divided in 15 to 20. What is present? Mammary lobes are present. Again here one pair mammary gland is present. In each gland granular tissue and the various amount of fat is present. But now we are talking about the granular tissue. So in that granular tissue 15 to 20 mammary lobes are present. This mammary lobes are very important. Now slowly we are coming from the outer side to the inner sidal structure, that is called the internal structure, and that's why we are taking that the first the with cells or the tissue are present, and now what is the internal structure present inside the tissue. So here we are taking that the granular tissue, and that 50 to 20 mammary lobes are present. Now this lobes, they are containing the cluster of cell. This mammary lobes, they are contain clusters of cell, and that is called alveoli. Okay, you studied in 11th. Where the alveoli is present? Alveoli is also present in the other part of our body. So where it is present? So yes, it is present into the lungs. In the lungs, alveoli are present, which is the main area for the transfer of the O2 and CO2. They are transporting O2 and CO2. Okay, so here they are containing clusters of cell, and they are known as the what? Alveoli. So alveoli is for the what? A production of the milk. It is related with the what? Production of milk, or it is known as the secretion of milk. Milk is mainly secreted by the cluster of cells, and that is known as the what? Alveoli. But you know very well, if the milk is produced, then that milk is not completely utilized by the child. So it will be a store into the mammary gland. But where they are stored? So it is a store into the cavity of alveoli. So again, this clusters of cell open into the where? Cavity of alveoli. Where the milk store. Again, what is present? So here we are taking that it containing clusters of cell which are the produce of milk, which are stored, that milk is stored into the cavity of alveoli. They are stored over there. Afterward, it open into the mammary tubes. This all cavity are open in mammary tubes, or it is called the tubules. Okay, they all are open into the mammary tubules, but the mammary tubules are present in each lobe. They come together and open into the mammary duct. So we can say that, what we are able to say, that the tubules of each lobe open in, see here, this is a glandular tissue, okay, and we are going at the internal area. Now after here, okay, where it is open into the where? Cavity of alveoli. From that, now we are taking that what? They are open into the mammary duct. Now what happened? This is the initial area, okay. Afterward we are dividing again, we are what? Collecting them, that means we are putting them in one area. So here we are says that the open into the mammary tubules, this mammary tubules which are present in the each lobe, they are open into the where? So they are open into the mammary duct. They are open into the where? Mammary duct. Now this mammary duct open into wider part called ampulla. Clear? See, when we are talking about the oviduct, even at that time, when we are talking about the ampulla, so we are says that is what? A wider part. If you remember the internal structure of ear, there we are also discussed about the ampulla. It is also present. Okay, so that ampulla, it is also what? A wider part. So the wider part known as the ampulla. So now this one, or we can say that the mammary duct, this mammary duct open into the where? So they are open into the wider part, and that is known as the what? A ampulla. Now it is connected with the lactiferous duct. Through this duct, milk is what? Sucked out. The baby is suck out the milk from there. Clear? Again, we are taking the whole structure. Remember, here it is a mammary gland. Mammary gland is a very important for the care of baby. Now here that we are taking, here the number is a one pair, and it is what? A functional. What is present? Gland. Now then we are taking that in each mammary gland, there are the glandular tissue and the various amount of fat is present. And I told you, where the fat is present in the what? A tissue, then it is known as the adipose tissue. Afterward, we say that in each glandular tissue or in the glandular tissue, 50 to 20 mammary lobes are present. Afterward, in that mammary lobe, what is present? So, in the mammary lobes, cluster of cells are present. That is called the alveoli. Alveoli, they are the production of milk. They are the produce the milk. Afterward, what is present? Cavity of alveoli. They open into where? Cavity of alveoli. They are storing the milk. Afterward, it's open into the mammary tubules. Where they are open in mammary tubules. Afterward, these tubes of each lobe is open into the mammary duct. They are open into the which area? Mammary duct area. Then, it open into the wider part, and that wider part, it is known as the what? Ampulla. Afterward, this ampulla, it is open, it is or the connected with the lactiferous duct. And this lactiferous duct is sucked out by the baby and the milk is come out. Remember, I hope you clearly understand that. Initially, what we are doing? So, that is a single part that we are divide. And afterward, we are merging them. Okay. So, the one part, this lactiferous tubules or sorry, duct are present into the nipple area. And that's why it is sucked out by the babies. If you see the picture, then it will be a more clear. See, here you are able to see that this is the what a fat. Fat is present at the both the side, red color. Then what is present? So here you are able to see that here this is the mammary lobes are present. This one, okay, that we have says that the glandular tissue in that what is present? Mammary lobes are present. Then they are containing cluster of cell, alveoli. So here, this is the alveoli. The single unit, they all are known as the what are alveoli. After that, they are, see, containing the cluster of cell that is called the alveoli. Alveoli are open into the where? Cavity. And then it is open into the mammary tubules. So see, this is this part. Okay, this, here you can say that the long cells are present. And this long cells, they are known as the what? A mammary tubules. Then afterward, it is open into the part that is called the ampulla. See, here the big wider part, frontal side, that is called the ampulla. And afterward, this one at the nipple area, you are see, this is called the lactiferous tubules. Here, this is, here, it is called the lactiferous tubules. So it is sucked out and the milk is come out from the mother's body. So, this type of structure of the mammary gland is present. Now, here, we are completing the female reproductive system. That means, we can say that if we want to study about the gametogenesis, we have to study about the male and female reproductive system. So, in this chapter, initially, we study about the what are two structure. Number one, that is called the male reproductive system, and number two, that is called the female reproductive system. These two systems are very essential to study, to understand for the what study the development or the formation of the what are gametes. Now here we are take the another topic, and that is called the gametogenesis. First we are studying here the male and female reproductive system, and now we are study about the function of all the organ. That we study that the testes are produce the what a sperm, then it is enter into the which area? So it is open into the different part, accessory duct, then the accessory glands are secrete and they are forming a semen. Okay, and afterward how they are coming out the body of the male. So, this thing and which part, which thing are the essential for that? We studied all the. Now, we will study very important thing that is called the gametogenesis. Gametogenesis are always present into the main part of the reproductive system. If it is a male, then it is what a testes. If it is female, then it is known as the ovary. These two things are there. If it is male, then it is known as the what a spermatogenesis. If it is female, then it is called the oogenesis. Okay, because we know that the testes, ovary, they are the organs, and that's why they have the two end structure. But when from that sperms are formed, they are in N condition. And we know very well, gametes are always haploid. So how this diploid structure converted into the haploid structure, into the male and female, that we have to study over here. If this N structure is converted into the 2N structure, and both will be a 2N, mother and father, so what happened? The baby should have the ploidy, that means the 4N structure. So you think that that baby is able to survive? No. That baby has to be compulsory needed the amount of the gene which is present in their parents. And that's why this gametogenesis is very important. Even this is very important for your exams. Gametogenesis and the oogenesis. Now we studied that we start with the first topic, and that is known as the what? A spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis, that means it is related with the production of sperm. It is very important to know about that, how the sperm are produced and what is the structure or structure of that. Now the sperm, they are not directly produced in one step. It needed a two step for the production. Initially only the cells are present, and afterward by the spermiogenesis, they are getting the proper structure of the sperm. But before to study that, we have to study about the section of seminiferous tubules. In our previous lecture, we say that if you take a section of the testes, then you are able to see that the seminiferous tubules, they are 2 to 3. This seminiferous tubules, they are present. Okay. Here, the lower side. The structure is present. This is a structure which are related with the what? A production of the sperm. It is a mainly produce the what? A sperm. That is called genital epithelia. They are related with the what? A production of the sperm. That means the initial cells are developed from that. So, when we study about the seminiferous tubules, at that time we are says that there are the two type of the cells are present. One, male germ cells, and other cell that is called the Sertoli cell. Even at that time we discussed that the male germ cells, they have the 4 to 8 layer. How many layers are present? 4 to 8 layers are present. So, here if we start with that, then we are says that initially, the first cell is present over here, and that is known as the what? A spermatogonium. The initial cell named spermatogonium. This is the first cell that you can say that the male germ cells, or it is called the what? A waist structure, spermatogonium. This is a 2N structure. Afterward, it will be developed into the primary spermatocyte. It is converted into what? Primary spermatocyte. Then it is converted into the secondary spermatocyte. Afterward, the secondary spermatocyte, that will be converted into the what? A spermatids. And afterward, they are converted into the what? A spermatozoa. That means the initial structure in that, what is present? So that is called what? A spermatozoa. This structure is present, that we are calling what? A spermatid. and then spermatozoa. This structure is present over there. Afterward, that we have says that here, what is present? So here the Sertoli cells are present. Sertoli cells are present in between germ cells. Now here, this is the cell. Afterward, what is present? So here the upper side. Another structure is present and that is called the Sertoli cell. Here the Sertoli cells are present. Now sperm are not directly come out, but the sperms, they are. What happened? So they are present or the embedded into the Sertoli cells. Okay. Remember the spermatozoa, they are also known as the sperm. Okay. So they are not directly come out, but they are come out by the which process? So they are embedded into the what? A Sertoli cell. First we says that Sertoli cells, they are always related to provide a nutrition, and that's why the Sertoli cells are very important. Now here we are take the structure into the chart of the spermatogenesis. But remember, in male, spermatogenesis is start at the puberty, but it is formed up to the lifespan. Okay, but in female, there are the different things. Remember the spermatogenesis, they have the same structure like the oogenesis. Something difference they have. But remember one thing here. In male, it is start from the puberty and it is present up to the what? The life span. So now we are study. We are start with this structure and that is known as the what? A spermatogenesis. So how the spermatogenesis will be a form? So that we are taking that at the puberty. In the male, what is present? So they are form the what? Spermatogonia. What they are forming? Spermatogonia. This spermatogonia, it has a 46 chromosomes. Remember, in your book and in this chart, only the one difference. And the difference is that here the chromosome numbers are given aside, that I am taking inside. If you write like that, then it is not a wrong. Okay. So spermatogonia, in that what is present? 46 cells are present. It is not mentioned in our book, but we remember that spermatogenesis is divided in three parts. Number one, it is a multiplication phase. Multiplication, that means cells are continuously divided. And because of that, they are forming the so many cells from the where a epithelium. Afterward, it is entered into the growth phase, where in that the chromosomes, some organelles, they are developed and they are increased into the size. And that's why it is known as the what? A growth phase. And at last, it is entered into the maturation phase. In that, the sperms, they are completely mature and then they are ready for the fertilization. So here that we are taking that at the puberty, spermatogenesis is present, spermatogonia is present. That spermatogonia, in that 46 cells are present. The cells, they are divided. So they all are the 46 cell. Why? Because this dividation is done by the what? A mitosis, not a meiosis. Cause where the cells are multiplying continuously, there always mitosis will form. And with that, what is present? Differentiation. Why differentiation? Cause it has to be divided in two cells. So the differentiation, these two things are present. And ultimately, the cells are converted into the primary spermatocyte. What we are calling that? Primary spermatocyte. It is called what? A primary spermatocyte. Now in your book, they say that this primary spermatocyte, they are nothing but they are the spermatogonia. If you simply think, then what happened here? One cell is present. What present? Mitosis. It is converted into the multiple cell. So after the multiplication by the meiosis, you can't see that they are the different cell. They are the same cell. If the kidney cells, they are continuously divided, so you can't see that the cells are now converted or the cells are become a stomach cell. They are remain a kidney cell. Same way here, the spermatogonia is by the mitosis continuously divided, so the cells are known as a spermatogonia. But we are just giving a different name, and the name is what? A primary spermatocyte. Now this primary spermatocyte, they are start a dividation. Okay, and what happened here? Now the meiosis will start. I told you that, and you know very well. We studied in chapter number 10, where the gametes are produced at that time. Always it is a process of the meiosis, and we know that meiosis are divided into meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. So here, when the process will start, the cells are divided, and now it is converted into the 23 pair of the chromosome, and this one is known as the what? A secondary spermatocyte. They are the what? A secondary spermatocyte. Now this process is happened by the meiosis 1. You know that meiosis are two type, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. So here this is called the secondary spermatocyte, and now it is a converted what? They are the first meiotic division. Afterward, what happened? Now the secondary dividation occur, and it is converted into the spermatids. Here it is a meiosis 2. Okay, same here, cells are developed. They will know that 23 23, here again 23 and 23, they are known as the what? A spermatids. Okay, after the spermatids, they are enter into the differentiation. They enter into the where? Differentiation, and ultimate they are converted into the spermatozoa. Where they are converted? Spermatozoa. So here that we can say that this cells, they are converted into the what? This type of structure. So four structures are developed. Okay, and this is called what? A spermatozoa. That is known as the what? A sperm. Okay, by the what? A differentiation. By the what? Differentiation. And that's why that I told you that what is present over here. So initially the process is started. This process, it is called the spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis, the initially what is present? Spermatogonia. In that what is present? 46 chromosomes are present. They are divided by the mitosis, and they are the continuously divide and form so many cells. Now it is called the primary spermatocyte. This spermatocytes, what is present in that? Meiosis 1. Because of that, now the 46 chromosome converted into 23, that is known as the secondary spermatocyte. Again, this spermatocytes by the process of meiosis 2, and they are forming what? A spermatid. And afterward, when the spermatids are formed, they are enter into the other thing, and that is known as the what? A what it is called? Spermiogonia. The spermiogenesis, in that what is present? So the we can say that spermatids are converted into the spermatozoa, and afterward, when the finally the sperm are released from the where? So it is released from the seminiferous tubules. It is known as the what? A spermiation. What it is called? Spermiation. Again, process name is spermatogenesis. So what is developed? Sperm. Initial from the genitalia of epithelium, genetic epithelium, what will be developed? Spermatogonia. How many chromosome? 46. What will happen? Mitosis. and what? Differentiation. Cells are continuous divide. So they are forming so many cells. So the chromosomes are remaining same. So ultimate which cells they are? Spermatogonia. But the name will be a change. And the name is what? Primary spermatocyte. This primary spermatocyte enter into the meiosis 1. And now they are from 46 chromosome converted into 23 chromosome. It is known as the secondary spermatocyte. Again, it is enter into the mitosis 2. And they are divided into the further, that is called the spermatids. After the spermatid, they are differentiate, or that I told you, it is known as the what, a spermiation. And because of that, what happened? So they are converted into sperm or the spermatozoa. And afterward, this sperm are the release from the seminiferous tubules, that is called the spermiation. Today, we are stopped up to here. I hope you will properly understand. If you have any query, then you can ask a questions on this channel, or even you can ask on my number.